furnace is a device in which the chemical energy of fuel or electrical energy is converted into heat, which is then used to raise the temperature of burden ion stock placed within it. A metallurgical furnace should have 1. A refractory chambers. 2. Hearth. 3. Burner. 4. Chimney. 5. Charging and discharging doors. This video aims to give an overview of some of the various types of furnaces used for metallurgical and industrial application. Welcome to James Saw Channel. Types of furnace. 1. Crucible furnace. A crucible furnace is a simple and very old type of melting unit commonly used in foundry. It is used for the melting of non-ferrous metal. The crucible furnace typically uses a refractory crucible which contains a metal charge. The actual crucible is a container that can withstand very high temperature, and its capacity may range from 30 to 50 kilograms. The charge is heated using conduction through the walls of the crucible. It's usually fueled by either coke, oil and gas or electricity. Metals such as titanium, which must be protected from air, while hot, are melted in hermetically sealed crucibles. Types of crucible furnace. Pit furnace. Coke-fired stationary furnace. Oil-fired tilting furnace. Pot furnace. Modes of discharge in a crucible furnace. 1. Tilting. Mechanically tilt the crucible to the mold. 2. Lift out. Lifting out then pouring it into the mold. 3. Bail out. Ladle the metal out to the mold. Advantages of crucible furnace. 1. Low maintenance cost. 2. Low oxidation losses. 3. Ability to change alloys quickly. Disadvantages of crucible furnace. 1. High emissions. 2. Low efficiency. 3. Size limitations. 2. Open hearth furnace. The open hearth furnace was first developed by German-born engineer Carl Wilhelm. Open hearth furnace is one of several kinds of furnaces in which excess carbon and other impurities are burnt out of pig iron to produce steel. Since steel is difficult to manufacture owing to its high melting point, normal fuels and furnace were insufficient, and the open hearth furnace was developed to overcome this difficulty. Advantages of open hearth furnace. 1. The process is economical because by using regenerative firing, heat is produced with less fuel consumption. 2. The process is suited to handle any amount of low-cost steel scraps. 3. Open hearth furnace are capable of processing iron of almost any chemical composition. Disadvantages of open hearth furnace. 1. High initial cost. 2. Limited control of furnace atmosphere. 3. Large floor space requirements. 3. Shaft furnace. Shaft furnace are used for melting, smelting and calcining. They are either cylindrical or rectangular shaft, through which the solid charge flows down under gravity, into the space vacated by discharge of solids or liquids or by gasification of parts of the charge. Iron blast furnace is the most highly developed shaft furnace and can operate very efficiently, not only as a heat unit but as a high temperature reaction chamber. Cupola furnace is also an example and aluminum shaft melting furnace. Advantages of shaft furnace. 1. High efficiency. 2. Moderate capital expenditure. 3. Continuous feeding, continuous tapping, suitable for large-scale continuous production. Disadvantages of shaft furnace. 1. insufficient degree of raw material decarbonization. 2. Non-uniformity of calcination, which increases as diameter increases and furnace height decreases. 3. High energy consumption rate. 4. Bessemer's converter. The Bessemer's converter is a cylindrical steel pot approximately 6 meters, 20 feet, high. Originally lined with a siliceous refractory. Air is blown in through opening, 2 layers, near the bottom, creating oxides of silicon and manganese, which become part of the slag, and oxide of carbon, which are carried out in the stream of air. Within a few minutes, an ingot of steel can be produced, ready for the forge or rolling mill. An opening of the narrow upper portion of the Bessemer's converter allows iron to be introduced and the finished product to be poured out. Melting of metal is typically accomplished with coal and coke fires. Advantages of Bessemer's converter. 1. The cost of building a Bessemer's converter plant is comparatively less than that of an open hearth plant of equivalent capacity. 2. Very efficient and creates an ingot in only a few minutes. 3. The flexibility is all the more attractive. Disadvantages of Bessemer's converters. 1. The Bessemer's converter had a low retention percentage of nitrogen in the newly formed steel. 2. The Bessemer's converter required phosphorus-free iron, as this process did not properly remove phosphorus and sulfur, two elements harmful to iron. 5. Muffle furnace. Muffle furnace or muffle oven refers to a type of jacketed enclosure that is used to heat a material to significantly high temperature, while keeping it contained and fully isolated from external contaminants, chemicals or substances. Muffle furnaces are usually lined with stainless steel, making them largely corrosion resistant. They are also used in many research facilities, for example by chemists, in order to determine what proportion of a sample is non-combustible and non-volatile. The heat source may be gas or oil burners, but more often they are now electric. Advantages of muffle furnace. 1. Simple structure and convenient operations. 2. Wide application range and no heating limitations. Disadvantages of muffle furnace. 1. Product of varying quality and difficult to choose. 2. Low heating rates. 3. Heating components are easy to damage and inconvenient to replace. 6. Soaking pit furnace. A furnace for heating steel ingots before rolling. Soaking pit are installed at the front ends of blooming and slabbing mill, which are usually used for rolling ingots weighing not less than 2 to 3 tons. Soaking pits are batch furnaces that are characterized by heat and temperature conditions that varying in time. Soaking pits are usually heated with blast furnace or coke oven blast furnace gas. Soaking pits are classified according to design features as regenerative, recuperative and electrical. Advantages of soaking pits furnace. 1. High quality heating of the metal. 2. Control of the heating condition can be automated. 3. Efficiency in the use of space in the building. Disadvantages of soaking pit furnace. 1. Inadequate design of the fuel combustion system and the difficulty of automating the heating process. 2. A disadvantages of the soaking pit with heating from the center of the bottom is air loss in the recuperators. 7. Reheating furnace. Reheating furnaces in steel plants are used in hot rolling mill to heat the steel stock, billet, blooms or slabs to temperature around 1200 degrees Celsius, which is suitable for plastic deformation of steel, and hence for rolling in the mill. Reheating furnace are divided into two general classes, batch type, continuous type. The continuous reheating furnace is of two major type, walking beam furnace, a pusher furnace. Walking beam furnaces are essentially state-of-the-art reheating furnace that are extremely efficient. The stock to be processed is kept on stationary ridges, with a revolving beam that moves it along as well as through the furnace. A pusher furnace is a continuous furnace concept that allows the processing of small and large products in trays and basket. Advantages of Advantages of reheating furnace. For batch types, they're suitable as a reservoir, for holding hot steel directly from the primary mill, for later rolling in the finish mill. For pusher types, low maintenance, ease in charging and drawing, less trouble from temperature inequalities between each succeeding piece drawn. For walking beam, pile-ups and furnace retention time are reduced. Disadvantages of reheating furnace. For batch type, high capital investment per unit of production, low hearth area efficiency, lack of flexibility, and limitations of length of pieces to be heated. For pusher type, difficulty in pushing mixed sizes through furnace, lack of flexibility for heating efficiently small orders of different lots of steel or thickness. For walking beam type, system complexity, high cost, and possible problem from scale that drops off the stock being heated. 8. Annealing furnace. Annealing is a heat treatment process that is used to alter the chemical or physical properties of a metal to make it more ductile and reduce its hardness. An annealing furnace works by heating it above its crystallization temperature and then cooling once the sample has been maintained at this temperature for a suitable amount of time. During the annealing process, the atom within the samples diffuse in the crystal lattice, and the number of dislocation reduces, changing the ductility and hardness properties of the sample. Recrystallization occurs as the sample cools down. There are three stages in an annealing furnace: recovery, recrystallization, grain growth. The recovery stage occurs at the lower temperature of the process. It's where the material being annealed is softened by the removal of linear defects called dislocations and the internal stress they induces. The recrystallization stage is where new strain-free grains nucleate and grow to replace those that were removed in the recovery state. Grain growth only occurs once the recrystallization has finished, and if annealing is allowed to continue. During grain growth, the microstructure of the material start to coarsen, and the material can lose some strength, so further heat treatment would be required. Advantages of annealing furnace. 1. Easy to use. 2. The temperature in the furnace rises rapidly, and the temperature in each section is uniform. Disadvantages of annealing furnace. 1. Maintenance is difficult. 2. Low degree of automation control. 9. Rotary kiln furnace. A rotary kiln is a pyroprocessing device used to raise materials to a higher temperature, calcination, in a continuous process. Material produce using rotary kiln includes cements, refractories, titanium dioxides, vermiculite, lima, metakaolin, alumina, iron ore pellets. The basic components of a rotary kiln are the shell, the refractory lining, support tires, riding rings, and rollers, drive gears and internal heat exchanger. Rotary cements kiln can be classified into wet process kiln, dry kiln and pre-calciner kiln, semi-dry kiln, preheater kiln. Advantages of rotary kiln. 1. High operating temperature. 2. Ability to handle a variety of wastes. Disadvantages of rotary kiln. 1. High capital and operating cost. 2. The need for trained personnel. 10. Electrothermal furnace or graphite furnace. Graphite furnace atomic absorption spectroscopy, also known as electrothermal atomic absorption, is a type of spectrometry that uses a graphite-coated furnace to vaporize the sample. A graphite furnace is made up of a graphite tube at both ends with a hole in the center for the sample introduction. The tube is encased with graphite electrical contact at both ends that serve to heat the sample. A supply of water is used to keep the graphite furnace cool. An external stream of inert gas flow through the tube, carrying away vapors from the sample matrix. Note: a graphite furnace is generally considered an ultra-trace and micro-trace analytical technique, with limits of detection in the low picogram range precision of a few percent, and a dynamic range of about 3 order of magnitude. Advantages of graphite furnace. 1. Provide enhanced sensitivity because samples are atomized quickly, and have a longer residence time, which means more of the sample are analyzed at once. 2. This furnace can also be used for qualitative determination, based on signal pack heights and area. 3. Offers the advantage of smaller sample size, and reduces spectral interference because of the high temperature of the graphite furnace. Disadvantages of graphite furnace. 1. Slow measurements time because of the heating and cooling required of the system. 2. A limited analytical range.